If you're going to be successful in the music business, you can't just sell records as a topless woman. You have to sell records to the people that live between Cleveland and Denver, you know, what they call white middle class America. That was my most difficult job. And then I decided the most edgy, forward-thinking influence in our society was the skateboarders and the surfers in Huntington Beach. I said, now, who do these guys like? I said, well, they like Guns N' Roses, they like Metallica, they like Suicidal Tendencies. So that I sort of honed in, and if you look at any Guns N' Roses or Metallica or Suicidal Tendencies interview or video that they did in those years, I'm sure you'll see them wearing a Compton hat or a Straight Outta Compton t-shirt. Once they gave their stamp of approval to NWA, then all those 26 million people that bought Appetite for Destruction, you know, knew that that was something cool and something they wanted to be involved with. You know, 3 or 4 of us into NWA, they did a 10-page spread in Foreign L magazine called Gangster Chic.